वेलकम टू EPG पाठशाला. द मॉड्यूल विल बी डिस्कशिंग इज वाटर मैनेजमेंट एंड कंजर्वेशन स्ट्रेटजीज. एंड द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर टू लर्न वेरियस वाटर कंजर्वेशन टेक्नोलॉजीज, टू नो वेरियस वाटर कंजर्वेशन प्रैक्टिसेस, टू नो वेरियस वाटर कंजर्वेशन स्ट्रेटजीज. नाउ द इंट्रोडक्शन. एज यू नो, द वाटर इज 70% अवेलेबल ऑन अर्थ इन वेरियस फॉर्म्स, एंड इट इज यूज फॉर वेरियस ड्रिंकिंग, फॉर ड्रिंकिंग पर्पजेज, फॉलोड बाई इंडस्ट्री, एग्रीकल्चर पर्पजेज, डोमेस्टिक नीड्स. And it is assumed that by 2020, India will be a water-stressed country with about 1600 cubic millimeter per person per day. And the health of the majority of Indians is far more from the satisfaction of the developed countries. And the quality of the water and the quantity management is one of the major problem which where we have to improve the resources of water conservation. Now, first, what is water conservation? Water conservation measures are the first line option for the control and management of water. Now, main question is, what is water conservation? Any beneficial reduction in water use or in water losses is defined as water conservation. And conservation measures involve reducing the mass emission of drainage water, and these are included as under: first, source reduction through sound irrigation water management; secondly, shallow water table management; and third is groundwater management; and the last is land retirement. How we can do water management? So, in order to meet the needs of existing and future populations, nation's water must be sustainable and renewable. Sound water resource management emphasizes carefully efficient use of water and is essential to achieve the objectives of water conservation. What is water management? Water management is the activity of planning, developing, distribution, managing and optimum use of water resources under defined water policies and regulations. Now, water conservation measures. What are the various schemes or technology by which we can conserve the water? First is development of water saving technologies, watershed management, desalination, extended retention wetlands, management policy, and water management strategies. Now, coming to first, development of water saving technologies. In developed countries, water leakage is less than 3%. Whereas in India, water leakage or pilferage is at 45% at the most. Implementation of water conservation or efficiency measures are more economic than development of new supplies, treatment and distribution of infrastructure. Dams and reservoirs can cost $4,000 per 1,000 gallon of capacity, whereas water efficiency cost between $0.46 to $250 per 1,000 gallon saved or new capacity. Now, coming to the water utilities practices, there are six best water utility practices. First is water system management, that is supply side and demand side accounting. Second is water loss minimization, that is like leak management. Then another is metering of consumed water. Then another is conservation rate structure. Then end use water conservation and efficiency analysis, water conservation and efficiency plan. Then coming to water system management, supply side and demand side accounting, opportunities to reuse water, the multi-tap supply system plan and plumbing systems. And to minimize the water loss, we can do the leak management, like leakage represents the largest real loss of water. Operational problems such as excessive pressure or rapid change in pressure, corrosion, seasonal stress, leak site connection and fittings, and accidental or deliberate damage. Apparent losses have been clearly defined as constituting four components, and that these components can act and interact interchangeably. For example, in diagram you can see that existing apparent loss is due to water counting errors, meter under regulation, meter reading errors, or water theft also. Now, the metering of consumed water. Domestic water supply using meter and water charge leads efficient use of domestic water. Metering utilities should not only implement at end users, but also of all water sources, including groundwater, surface water, water purchases, and or reclaimed water. For example, in case of Navdeep apartment, a society named namely Panchshil Mem Nagar Cooperative Housing Society Limited, Vibhag 1 in 1995 achieved the significant reduction in water as well as electric current. Navdeep experience of water meter proves that before installation of meter, electricity bill was around 2.3 times higher. Now, how we can do the conservation rate structure? Managing demand through pricing can also be an advantage. Then tiered fees system, like conservation pricing, can be accomplished with a tiered fee system. And by increasing block rates have been favored in many recommendations as most likely to support conservation oriented behaviors by end users. Now, how end use water conservation and efficiency analysis is done? It is necessary to identify which efficient water conservation programs and policies will be most effective. A water utility need to understand the makeup of its customer base and conduct a thorough assessment of end use water efficiency measures. For example, low flow plumbing fixtures and retrofit programs are permanent one-time conservation measures that can be implemented with little or no additional cost over the lifetime of the fixture. Commonly recommended low flow plumbing fixture are pressure reduction devices, faucet aerators, toilet displacement devices, low flush toilets, low flow slower heads, and plumbing modifications for grey water use. Now, water conservation and its efficiency plan. The main idea is to capture water that has been used once and treat it to a sub-potable standard and then reuse it for purposes that does not require drinking grade water. Aside from toilet flushing and irrigation, that can also include using the stuff to cool a building and avoid using a costly air conditioning unit. Now, coming to watershed management urgently required to absorb the climate shocks. In India is well enriched with the knowledge of hydrology science for water conservation. The floods and droughts were regular occurrences in ancient India, and this is why every region in country had its own traditional water harvesting techniques. For example, in Indus Valley civilization, cities are well evidenced by the excavation having excellent water harvesting and drainage system. And according to Indian mythology, it is well documented with the story of one of the disciples of Rishi named Aruni. Now, coming to water harvesting, what is harvesting? Water harvesting, it is the process of concentrating precipitation through runoff and storage for beneficial use. Water harvesting may occur by naturally or by interventions. And there are different water harvesting techniques, for example, micro catchments, macro catchments, flood water harvesting, and storage reservoirs. Now, first, coming to rainwater harvesting. So, what is rainwater harvesting? Rainwater harvesting is a technology used for collecting and storing rainwater from rooftops, the land surface, or rock catchments using simple techniques such as jars and pots, as well as more complex techniques such as underground check dams. And it includes principal components like the catchment area, the collection device, and the conveyance system. Now, coming to the design of landscape detention basin. For this, proper planning and design of contours of landscape basins for watershed management is required. An example is porous landscaping detention, also known as PLD, has been widely used to increase on-site infiltration. Providing water retention at shade tree planting allows for fuller growth of trees to assist in shading the house for energy conservation. And suitably designed landscape detention basin enhancement facility intended to capture and filter runoff. And there is example of various landscape detention bases. For example, one is cityscape. Cityscape is a water-wise gardening. Cityscaping is a term coined and trademark also in Denver, Colorado. It uses planting and design features that are more suitable to a particular region, whether in the arid west or the more variable climate of the Northeast. Choosing plants that conserve water and designing landscape that protect the environment. Now, contour trenching or bunding can be done. It is one of the oldest method of water conservation, is digging of contour trenches and contour bunding across the slopes of grounds or field. They are usually installed to prevent small rills developing into gullies by limiting the area over which runoff collects, with or without sideways diversion into prepared waterways for safe disposal of downslopes. Another example is village tanks. It is also one of the oldest method of water conservation. A tank is a simple earthen banked rainwater harvesting and storage structure constructed with the generous support of native rulers and chieftains over the several past centuries. Since most tanks are man-made, they are usually called reservoirs. And simple technological innovations developed to accommodate primary needs and adapted to distinctive Indian climate, intense monsoons followed by the protracted droughts. Now, there is also improved irrigation system. These methods require precise grading of the topography, high instantaneous flow rates, and relatively high levels of automation and management. Micro irrigation is the slow rate of water application at discrete location at low pressure and includes trickle or surface drip, subsurface drip, micro sprinklers, and bubblers. Carefully managed subsurface drips provide the greatest potential for water conservation. Another example is raised beds and varu varu cultivation. This technology is based on modification of the soil surface to facilitate water movement and storage. This system of soil management for irrigation purposes was first developed in the year 300 BC before the rise of Inca empires. The technology is a combination of rehabilitation of marginal soils, drainage improvement, water storage, optimal utilization of available radiant energy, and attenuation of the effects of frost. Another example is clay pot and porous capsule irrigation. This technology consists of using clay pots and porous capsules to improve irrigation practices by increasing storage and improving the distribution of water in the soil. The clay pot system of irrigation consists of pots or a series of pots connected with plastic tubing, and it is easy to install and also easy to operate and maintain. This ancient system has been modernized and reapplied in water scarce areas. The system is recommended for home vegetable gardens, for example 10 to 20 pots, and also for small orchards in rural communities. Another example is bamboo drip irrigation. In the Meghalaya, an ingenious system of tapping of stream and spring water by using bamboo pipes to irrigate plantation is widely prevalent. About 80 to 20 liters of water entering the bamboo pipes per minute get transported over several hundred meters and finally gets reduced to 20 to 80 drops per minute at the site of plant. The tribal farmers of Khasi and Jaintia Hills use this 200-year-old system. The bamboo drip irrigation system is based on gravity, and the steep slopes facilitate in implementing it. Another example is percolation tanks. The best way to provide dry season recharge is to create small storage at various places in the basin by bunding gullies and streams. Such storage created behind earthen bunds put across small streams is popularly known as percolation tanks. In semi-arid regions, an ideal percolation tank with catchment area of 10 square kilometer or so hold maximum quantity by the end of September, and it allows to percolate for next 4 to 5 months during winter. Groundwater movement being very slow, whatever quantity percolates between October and March is available in the wells on the downstream side of the tank even in the summer months till June or the beginning of next monsoon season. Another example is check dams. It is a small temporary or permanent dam constructed across a drainage ditch, swale or channel to lower the speed of concentrated flows for a certain design range of storm events. Check dam can be built from wood logs, stones, pea gravel filled with sandbags or brick and cements also. The rainwater collected and stored will improve groundwater level in the open wells situated nearby, providing water supply for agriculture under open wells. All topographic characteristics should be studied in detail before gully plugging work begins. Now, another example, porous landscape retention, also known as PLD. It is a recent regional flood event recognition of the impact of developed and rapidly developing areas on water quantity and quality are the main issues requiring special management planning. Porous landscape retention is one of the most common types of stormwater management facilities utilized. Porous landscape retention consists of a low-lying vegetated area underlain by a sand bed with a under-drain pipe. The area with sufficient water retention facilities can be developed as a constructed wetland basin. Another thing we can use are, these are super absorbent polymers. Super absorbent polymers are materials that have the ability to absorb and retain large volumes of water. Super absorbent polymer could be the future of irrigation water conservation. Water absorbency of some of the absorbent material in comparison with typically commercial SAP sample, for example Wattman filter paper number 3, its water absorber efficiency is 180%. Similarly, facial tissue paper, it has water efficiency absorbency of 400%. Soft polyurethane sponge, it has 1050. Wood pulp fluff, it has 1200%. Cotton ball, it has 1890. And Super Ab A 200, it has 20,200% water absorbency. Another thing we can do is artificial glaciers. The natural glaciers are shrinking due to rising of global temperature and results in water crisis. In 2014, a local mechanical engineer, Mr. Sonam Wangchuk, set out to solve the water crisis of Ladakh. Mr. Wangchuk had a simple idea. He wanted to balance this natural deficit by collecting water from melting snow and ice in cold months. Another thing is, what is desalination? Desalination is a process that removes dissolved minerals including salts from saline water and produces potable water. And now, why desalination is important? More than 3/4 of Earth's surface and more than 95% of the world's water is either salty or brackish and therefore not potable. Desalination has become increasingly important due to the tendency in recent years for the world's swelling population to dwell in areas where supplies of high quality fresh water sources are less than adequate. A number of technologies such as membrane process, distillation and vacuum freezing have been developed to perform desalination. Another thing we can do is extended retention wetlands. In this, wetland treatment system is there. It is a storm water or wastewater treatment system consisting of shallow ponds and channels vegetated with aquatic or emergent plants. This system relies on natural microbial, biological, physical and chemical processes to treat storm water or wastewater. Extended retention wetlands are among the most effective storm water practices in terms of pollutant removal, and they also offer aesthetic value. Now, coming to water management strategies, water resource management requires a shift in the attitude and behavior of the various stakeholders to move away from centralized top-down planning to community-driven location, specific people-centric planning. And water management strategies project do not depend solely on the good engineering and suitable agronomy for their success. Generally, same water management strategies are employed without consideration to different parts of the basin. In fact, it is necessary to provide simple framework to visualize water use in a basin and enable formulation of effective site-specific water management strategies. A water management strategy is a plan or a specific project to meet a need for additional water by a discrete user group, which can mean increasing the total water supply or maximizing an existing supply. Now, what are the various factors which are used in water management study assessment process include the quantity of water the strategy could produce, capital and annual cost, potential impacts the strategy could have on the state's water quality, water supply and agricultural and natural resources, reliability of the strategy during the time of drought, the opportunities for applying new technologies and making other changes in our management of the water resource must be fully assessed and implemented as soon as possible. The water resources shall be managed in such a manner that will result in a greatest long-term benefits of the people. So in conclusion, we can say that water management is necessary and you can utilize various water conservation strategies at your personal level, as well as the water conservation technology should be in long term benefit of the people. Thank you.